Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, in this video, we're gonna create our newsletter or our brochure, okay? We're gonna work on our margins, our columns, the gutters between it. We're gonna look at things called spreads. It's gonna be exciting. Let's go and do it. All right, so first thing we're gonna do is create a new document. Either click this button or you can go to File, New Document. Okay, and we're gonna start with some of the presets, print. Now, depending on the part of the world, we're gonna use A4 or letter. We'll use letter in this case. You can see mine keeps defaulting back to millimeters. It's mainly because in between making videos, I have to do work in InDesign and I work in millimeters, so I keep switching it back. Anyway, okay, so there's my sizes. I'm gonna work in portrait and we're gonna have facing pages turned on this time. Okay, a number of pages, we're gonna have 8. Just consider when you are making, say, a newsletter or a brochure, often you have to work in multiples of 4. You can have 2 pages, okay, so front and back of our US letter, but often when it gets past that, it's actually big sheets of paper folded in half and stapled. So you can't have, like, say, 6 pages, because you'll have one big sheet folded in half, and then you'll have this kind of like one sitting in the middle, and it becomes very hard to bind together. Okay, there's ways around it, but often you work in multiples of 8. If you've ever opened up the newspaper and pulled one sheet out of it, you know, you've dropped it into pieces and you pull out one sheet, you'll notice there's actually 4 sides, okay? So think of that when you are doing a newsletter. Definitely don't do 5 because you've got a back of a sheet of paper that you have to use. Okay, starting number. Okay, this might be that you've got a really long document and you've got pages and you want to start the page numbering on something different. Okay, we're going to keep our start to 1. Very rarely will I change that. Primary text frame we'll look at in a later video. Okay, columns. Okay, we haven't used this before. By default, you have to have a minimum of 1. What we're going to have is 3 in this case. And the gutter is the space between these columns. Just leave it to whatever the default is. Let's have a quick look at why we use columns. Okay, so in here, I've done a little search for magazine spreads. And what you'll notice is that when people are designing magazines, professionals, they will start with a number of columns and consistently use that throughout the magazine. And it gives a bit of consistency through, say, a really long document so that you're not going to every page, switching out different columns. It's one of the things that are really easy to notice when you're looking at kind of amateurs do work is that there's no consistency with columns. Okay, so often it's 2, 3, 4, or 5. Columns. Let's have a little look at some of the examples. Now you can break these rules kind of, okay, but it adds a bit of consistency throughout. Okay, so let's look at, say, this one here. It's an easy one. Okay, there's 3 columns. Okay, that's what we're going to be doing, and that is keeping to 3 columns. Let's have a look through, say, this one here. This one's a little bit different. Okay, they're using 3 columns. Okay, but they're kind of breaking the rules a tiny bit where they're spreading across some of these. Okay, so there's still 1, 2, 3. I know you're thinking, like, there's only 2 columns, but you can see this image here is actually spanning 2 of them. And they're doing the same thing over here, so there's still 3 columns, but this one here is spanning 2 of them. Let's have a look at some of the ones that, say, this one here, I'd say is maybe an amateur work, okay? Because there's just, I don't know, you can kind of see there's no real columns in there. This is not even, okay? So it should be 1 and then another 1 and then this one's a bit short. I don't know, I hope you can kind of see it. It feels like it's not, there's no consistency here. This one here doesn't span the columns like it should. And so it's got all the right ingredients for a great magazine, but I think columns can really help lift an amateur's work. Okay, this one here, 2 columns. This one here still is in that, I think, in the amateur category. It's cool, it's nice, but it's, columns I'm just unsure about. Okay, you see this one here, it's beautiful but crazy, but it's still using 4 columns. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, this big giant number 2 spans 2 of them, and that's okay, you're allowed to break the rules, but only breaking the rules within the rules, if you know what I mean. All right, that was a long explanation. Let's jump back into InDesign. So we're using 3 columns, okay, and margins we're going to use something slightly bigger, so we're gonna do 0.8 inches, okay? And you'll notice that it changed all of them at the same time because this little linking icon is set. I'm gonna break that now, so I wanna do all of them, except I wanna do the bottom to be a little bigger. It's gonna be 1.4 inches. Okay, now, if you're using millimeters, okay, I'm using 20 all around except for the bottom, which I'm using 35 millimeters. couple of things to know is often the bottom will be bigger than the rest of the document. It gives you a little bit of wiggle room down the bottom to put things like page numbers and document titles. It also just gives a nice, even if you're not going to put page numbers down there, it gives the document kind of a sort of grounding. It gives it kind of a base at the bottom. Okay, so it's just a visual footing. Okay, not sure how to explain it, but it's nice with a nice thick bottom on the bottom. What you'll also notice is there's no left and right, there's inside and outside. Okay, so if I turn facing pages off, can you see it becomes left and right, which we understand, but then facing pages on, it becomes inside and outside. That means if I jump back to my example, you can see here, it just means, look at this example here. Oh, it's a pretty big example. Okay, it is, you don't have a left and a right essentially, but you have an inside margin. Okay, and an outside margin. And what you often can do is you can have a slightly bigger inside margin if you've got something called creep. If you've got a really big thick magazine and maybe these pages are disappearing into the gap here, they call that creep. Okay, so you can kind of increase that. Our magazine's not big enough to worry about that. And often as a designer, even if your magazine is really big, that is often the role of the printer, okay, to start playing around with the creep and adjusting that for you. Okay, talk to them about it if you are worried about it, and often they'll help you out. Back to InDesign. Bleed. Okay, we're going to have our 0.125. Okay, unless you're in millimeters, and then it's 3 mil. And slug we never use. Okay, so we're going to click Create. Let's jump to our Pages panel. If you can't see it, let's go to Window, Pages, and just have a quick little look at what we've done. We've got 8 pages. Okay, so I've got page 1 here, and that's our cover, and then it moves to spreads. Okay, so I double click page 2, and you can see here, I'm going to zoom out, command minus or control minus on a PC. You can see they've put pages 2 and 3 together. You can have them separate, that's fine, but obviously when you're working on a magazine, it's handy to see them together. That's why we look at this word spreads. Okay, you want to see them together. Great work, let's go and save it. File save. Okay, and let's put it into our desktop. We've got our InDesign class files, and let's call this one Green at Heart, and this one's going to be our newsletter. V1, not final. Let's click save. All right, let's get into the next video. Let's look at something called Master Pages. Exciting. So, what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.